one more show tonight, so please give it up for the Post-Dinner Conversation Touring Company.
Sitting on top of the table.
There's a note card that says, "Deborah, I'm so sorry."
Behind the table, it's a huge heart that says, "Happy Valentine's Day. Hope I can make it up to you."
The giant heart is painted on a wall, a giant mural. And on the table is a single slender vase with a single slender rose.
Up above all of that are a bunch of pigeons, but they didn't want the pigeons to get away, so the pigeons' legs are tied to the roof.
The pigeons are painted white to look like doves.
And each one of them has one letter in "I'm sorry" painted on.
Wow, this is
all for you.
This is very intense.
This is what I wanted. Oh, sit down. You look ravishing tonight.
Sorry, I'm late. I'm just gonna set up the harp over here.
Alright. Hey, I'd like to go all out.
What else did you do?
Well, we'll find that out as the night.
I don't know whether to be surprised or kind of.
Hold on. Excuse me, welcome, here, yes, what can I get for you to start?
I'll have a water.
Now what the private hire, water for the gentleman, and what can I get you from the kitchen?
Alka-Seltzer?
Alka-Seltzer, we have.
You're so adorably weird.
Just straight, or with a drink?
Oh, yeah, with water, please. I would like water.
Very well.
I've tried just with just Alka-Seltzer.
Doesn't work, does it? No. It's very dry and chalky. I'll be right back.
Fantastic,
isn't it? Yeah. Wow, that accent.
Yeah, I know that you loved it, and I know it was something that you wished that I had. So I hired him to serve us.
Great. I always love
French people.
Yes, I love French people.
Hey, Bradley, did you tell her yet?
This is Marie, and she's also from France.
She's wearing a potato sack.
He's very sorry.
Did I miss something?
No, I just forgot to introduce.
This is the kind of party I like to be hired for. One Alka-Seltzer in the drink.
I'm gonna move to the accordion now.
I will be right back with the menus.
You're right, she does seem very open-minded.
I thought that she would like you, and I think she has. Look at the way she's drinking. Look at her eyes looking at you. She seems very comfortable.
Yeah.
What exactly? exactly is going on?
The entity behind her is actually a demon that is starting to slowly take hold of her and control her actions.
Honey, this is why you shouldn't eat Alka-Seltzer. It's weird. It's just...
I have a feeling I'm hungry.
We're going to order... Waiter!
Here I am, is it? Nope!
Here, you probably don't like her much, right? Happy Valentine's Day. I got you.
I want to eat the soul of a virgin!
So well.
Well, what?
Nah.
The CCTV is kind of fuzzy.
Yeah.
You can see it.
Yeah? We got at least 22 million viewers right now. It's all fuzzy and shit. I don't know what we're gonna do about it. I'm so nervous.
Don't worry. Live TV in France is different than in the south of America.
How did you know? That's exactly where I'm from.
It has nothing to do with you sounding like your nose looks.
Alright.
We see that he's wearing a white t-shirt with a blue jean overalls, and there's stains, mysterious stains all across the white shirt. Uh-huh.
And then we see him in a very French fitted suit. He has the little frills coming out, whatever that is, and a little like Marilyn Monroe's thing.
And a pencil-thin mustache.
Listen, my friend, we gotta call somebody about this. I love your little frills, by the way.
Okay.
Looking fantastic.
Thank you. It is combat bleu. It is.
Alright. See, I'm not familiar with that fancy speak. What does that mean?
It's something that you cannot comprehend.
Alright.
Listen, sir, when you sign up your wife for French live television, we will take certain liberties that may range anywhere from perhaps nudity, violence, possession, perhaps.
I know, I agreed to all that. That's why I signed the papers at the bottom. It's just that it's so grainy, nobody's gonna be able to see it.
Oh, you were worried about the exposure?
That is the problem.
Don't worry. Everybody in the country is seeing this now.
They're not seeing it. They're seeing something that looks like whole grain toast.
We zoom in on the television screen that they're watching, and we see a woman locked in a room on a black and white screen. It's really fuzzy, but we see a dark figure coming up behind her.
Stop it right now!
You see that he's completely in shadows, like he's made of shadows, with red eyes.
And she's wearing chicken footsie pajamas.
You didn't come dressed for the occasion.
You said animal sacrifice. I wanted you to sacrifice me.
I know, but I thought you were gonna bring the chickens. Not actually wear them.
I thought it'd be funnier. Like,
you thought wrong! This is a serious situation!
We see his sound waves bounce off and come back and hit him in the ears.
Ow! Jesus!
Did someone call for a knife costume?
Oh, no, I wanted a real knife! Why doesn't anybody listen to me?
His sound waves bounce off this wall and come back to his ears.
God damn it! No, we'll figure out something to do. Look, try to get into my palm. Look very menacing, nice looking. Oh, come on. Oh, come on. I have to lift you too. Okay. Jesus Christ, you guys are the worst people to have.
You're supposed to use me. I'm saying. I'm the blood of a hero type?
It's okay.
Jesus, you are a Heinz ketchup bottle. I don't need you. God, we're going to have to reschedule. This is not working out well.
your work.
I heard that.
And to be honest, people don't take you seriously anymore.
And he's saying that people think you're a load of crap.
Oh, I'm not a load of crap.
Yeah, you're also awfully loud all the time.
Your voice just hurts people's eardrums.
I'll try to be more quiet. You think the teenagers will like that?
We think you're going to have vocal damage if you do that.
He said we, but it's just, you know, his own internal monologue.
Well, I think there's not much more I can do. It's the lowest, softest I can go.
The whole shadowy thing, you know, you're black, man.
Well, what the hell, man? You're white! And he's white. What are you exactly?
You know, I just basically reiterate what he said, but with synonyms.
We don't feel like you're understanding us when we have these meetings, so we hired this guy.
Whoa, I feel like you guys aren't, you know, representing me with the right people. Why don't you get more shadow black people to come out here?
You want more black people on the show?
Well, shadow too!
I don't feel comfortable making synonyms for this conversation.
Thank God.
You're welcome.
Thanks, God.
For everything.
I think we should take a moment.
Okay.
I think we should focus on all the light in our lives. All the beautiful, brilliant light.
It's very, yes, bright.
Or any kind of day. Ah!
They are on the very top of a parking garage.
She's brought her own church pew for them to kneel on.
Ow. I think God was trying to tell me something.
I don't like you much.
Did you hear that? No.
In her mind.
Thank you for not letting that shadowy beast kill me last night.
Soft organ music plays.
Thank you for not allowing him to possess me. He did not look good, like a good person or thing. And I'm so happy that you...
Can you turn off that music in your head?
I can't help it.
Or anything, I just thought that, you know.
No!
You know, I mean, we could size it down. We could.
We've tried. We've tried talking to it. We tried flipping it over.
They are looking at furniture in IKEA.
Nothing's gonna work.
No.
Our house is too small. We shouldn't live in a doghouse. I was thinking about that the other day. Like how we're adults and like humans and like how we should live in a house that's like made for it.
I'm not trying to, you know, say anything to you with it. It's all I can afford for now. And I think the intimacy between us is growing because of it.
I mean,
it's a fairly large house.
Every time you pee, like I feel it.
Yeah.
That's what you mean by intimacy.
It kind of shakes a little bit. Mm-hmm. I gotta hold on to something when I go.
Right.
You know,
I thought that was charming at first, now it's just like, oh god.
Well, when it was your hand, it was okay, but now that it's become the house,
right,
kind of shakes down a little bit.
Well, we could go in the kids section.
Oh, I never even thought about that. That's not a bad idea.
No, it's not.
Like the Sklars and the Rokals and the...
Yeah. Hello, my name is Dave. Are you guys looking for something today?
Well, we live in a doghouse.
It's about that big.
As adults.
Well, that does not sound convenient at all.
Did I hear doghouse?
Oh, yes, you did.
Oh, my God.
Oh, man, look at this. The second best salesperson on this floor today.
Love it.
Oh. Did you know that Swedish people actually work here?
I didn't.
Of course, you would know all the fun words we have for all the things we see out here.
Oh, great. How do you pronounce that one?
Oh, man, you've got this one.
This is Gordingan. And that is Dorkin.
Oh, she did two of them for you instead of the one you asked for.
The way they look are actually the very way you say it.
Well, that's about right. That actually feels right. Well, the issue is that they're too big for our house. I mean, you guys are supposed to have versatile solutions for everything, and we're having relational tension because of this.
Oh, no.
Are you cueing her?
That is so bad for you. We did not assume that you'd be living in such a tiny little home.
Thankfully, you're at IKEA.
Why are we thankful for that? We
have the 10 meatballs that you can eat halfway through walking around.
Actually, they are delicious. They're really good.
Hello, I am the manager of this IKEA. I wanted to talk to you about your relationship issues. My two employees told me that you guys are having trouble working it out.
IKEA offers
you free meatballs. Okay, so now just talk to me, hash out your issues.
There's a psychology degree on the wall from like 1987.
I worked here and I earned my psychology degree. They're very expensive here in IKEA.
We actually see they're in one of the display living rooms.
So like this is a place to start, like, we don't have a lot of furniture or, like, napkins or anything. We usually just wipe our hands in the grass.
Well, if you go down aisle 3 and 4s, we have furniture and napkins.
I understand that. She wipes her hands on my clothing.
We also sell clothes here.
I think it's super sexy. I may be the only one who thinks that.
It's okay, we're all into weird things. My wife dresses up as a Swedish meatball sometimes.
Cut to that.
Honey, I'm looking for you.
I'm a meatball.
You just get me so turned on. Keep dripping all the meatball juice all over our bed.
Look at the knife.
So I get it. It's okay if you think it's a little sexy. Now, why do you have a problem with this?
There are people still shopping, right?
Mom! Mom!
So get up. that might be a problem.
Whoa.
Tell them more about how it sucks.
Hey, listen, what's your name again, Slim Yamanunina?
That's actually the perfect pronunciation of that name. Slim Yamanunina.
Sarcastic, I was making fun of your people. Listen, alright, as a CEO, sit down, I didn't say you could stand. As a CEO, we're all about business.
I'm sorry.
I don't know why you're bringing people up onto the displays and trying to make their marriage better.
Well, do you want people arguing in our stores?
Hey, are these showers on sale?
Yes, $14.99.
Thank you so much.
Wait, it might seem really hypocritical that I'm having you do this in one of the sets, alright?
Yes.
But I'm trying to prove a point, alright? A, you can't go trying to solve people's problems, and B, stuff like that's going to happen all the time.
What,
can I get a bigger shower?
Yes, the XL is on the other side of the shower.
Oh,
yes, and it has four different motions that you could change into.
But we're discussing your job right now, you might lose it.
And I'm doing fantastic at
it. Yeah, okay.
I just sold something.
But you brought a man and a woman back up onto one of our displays the other day and tried to fix their marital issues.
Yes, and then they ended up buying a love chair.
Really?
Yes! Four of them, to be exact.
Are you a manager?
No. I've been working here for 14 years. I went through schooling, and then you guys are so insistent on not promoting me.
All right. Look, I'm going to tell you, I misjudged you the first time. I think I'm going to give you a promotion here at this IKEA.
Oh, that would be great, sir!
Mom!
Your mom is over here at 5-7.
I go to IKEA all the time, but I never go of my own volition. I feel like I'm always drugged there by people. Not drugged today.
Could you imagine?
I feel like I always have to go with like family or something like that, which then I like get completely fucking lost because they take shortcuts and I don't. And I like my vanity like pulls me to the bed sections, and now I have an entire desk set.
When I first started going to IKEA, I was completely lost, and then I started a strategy of figuring out all the back ways and which ways you can't go and which ways that you can go. And I'm walking around. My family likes to go to IKEA because my mom's from Finland, which is right next to Sweden. And so she feels like going to IKEA is kind of fulfilling her Finnish roots, but...
My dad is full-blooded Cuban, and so he's like one of those guys that's like, I'm a Republican, put hair on your chest and shit, right? Because he like came here from Cuba. And we just found out last week, my brother finally came out of the closet. He is gay. I'm very happy about that. But my dad, I talked to him on the phone, and he was like, yeah, I love Justin to death. I love him, but at the same time, you know, in my heart of hearts, it just kills me inside. And I was like, that's a fucked up thing to say about your son, Dad. That's the end of my story.
Dad, I'm waiting for you to say something.
I don't know what to say.
Are you crying?
Yes, crying.
You've never cried before.
Well,
my family used to go on road. We're not going to make fun of my family.